To be honest, I love watching the fight. You get that adrenaline, my leg will just start shaking out of nowhere, like start getting hyped.
Last time I got into a scrap was a 5-on-1. I just see this big fucking Uso talking to my girlfriend. I'm like, fuck, this isn't gonna end well.
In New Zealand, like so many other places across the world, violent masculinity represents the ability to dominate another person.
They say toughen up and be a big man, but all my brothers wanna become. Everybody's like an actor. What's it mean to be a real one?
What it means to be a man in New Zealand is changing. There are more of us talking about our feelings and being open about our lives. This is a five-part series that looks at the issues affecting young men in New Zealand. I'm Philip, and I'll be chatting with my mates, Liam and Tioa. This is one for the boys.
Do you find yourself like in a lot of situations where you feel an expectation to fight?
Yeah, all the time, bro. It's like whenever I'm out with the boys, they always expect me to jump in. Always. They're like, oh, bro, yeah, if we suss these guys out, then you're in, right? And then just I've got to be like, yeah, sure. Just because you got to be boys. Because if, like, imagine if all your boys jump into a fight and you don't, and you're just the one standing there. You look like a pussy.
It doesn't just seem to be us. For a lot of other guys, violence is everywhere.
One night we were out at a party, and then there was a massive fight happening on the street. I seen someone younger than me in the fight, and I sort of went to go help him out. Yeah, I woke up on the ground. I didn't know what happened. And then later on, like, I got told that I got hit with a bat. I'm currently the lightweight stricken fight series champion. But there was no one really for me to fight. So I thought I'd jump up a weight. It'll be good to challenge myself. If all goes well on Saturday, I'm hoping to go pro after that. You know, I could just train for a living and fight for a living. That's the highest goal, definitely. I'd love to join the UFC one day. I always used to think I was the toughest around. Like, no one could stop me because I was used to getting hiding from my older brother. You know, if I can handle his punch, I can handle anyone's punches. Whenever we're at parties, something happened, I used to be like, oh yeah, what's happening? Think I was a hero or something. But that sort of changed the way I like looked at a lot of things. I had this massive cut on my lip and I was all swollen on my like cheek and stuff. But yeah, ended up going to A&E and they were saying if it was any higher, I could have got hit in the temple and probably not woken up. When Mum walked in, she was shocked and she started to tear up. It sort of made me sad and realise that, you know, if it was, like, if I didn't wake up to, like, see my mum, it'll break my heart, you know. I'm a mama's boy, so, you know, I love my mum.
When I saw him, I was devastated. I had to talk to him about where he's heading. And from then on, he seems to be going through the right direction for what he wants in his goal in terms of MMA. Anthony has done really well and I'm very proud of his achievements. I've been once to watch a fight and never again will I go. I just don't want to watch someone else beat my son up. And some of these guys are twice his age, you know, and it's horrible. It's horrible.
I don't know, I haven't gone into like a lot of fights, but the one that stands out was that like at a party, one of my mates got too touchy with a girl I knew, and then that was like a snap moment. Just went in looking for a fight, but as it came up, I knew that it wasn't gonna satisfy what I was after, and I could take myself out of that headspace, but in that instance, that was probably like the hardest to do that. Like having that like steam off you and that physically feeling like hotter.
Yeah.
A lot of it's rage. I just want to destroy my enemy.
I feel like it's like blind rage.
Yeah, yeah.
But I feel like you, in the moment, there is like a hint of guilt. You suppress it too. Like in the back of your head, you know you shouldn't be doing it, but you want that payoff so bad that you just listen to it afterwards. Actually felt like a little kid, not being able to control my emotions. I think the part where I felt the most like adult about it was reflecting upon it, knowing why I felt the reasons I did, and kind of learning from it afterwards.
It was my brother that really pushed me to MMA. I reckon the biggest difference is, you know, you train, you do an 8-week camp just to fight in a cage, fight once. That person you're fighting is real technical and he understands the fight game. It's a game of chess, like, oh, if you move, I'm gonna move. If you make me flinch, I'm gonna make you flinch, or I'm gonna counter you. Whereas in a fight outside of the cage, everyone just goes all out.
When I first met Amos, yeah, he was a chubby little kid, eh? And he walked into the gym wanting to lose weight, and I thought, oh, I don't know, eh? I think he had a few anger issues, and you know, we try to teach him still discipline and self-control. I think all of that has got into him now, you know? He doesn't really have to prove anything. I think there's a few problems, you know, we need to address with the youth growing up now. Most people from where I come from South Africa, they don't have a problem with emotions and to cry and stuff. I cry, I'm not scared to cry, you know? A lot of guys say in New Zealand, I'll just swallow a concrete pill, you know, toughen up and man up. I was with Youthline for like 7, 8, 9 years that I've been in New Zealand, and I try and mentor a lot of the students here. You need to talk, man. Get it out of your system, confide in people. I'm not worried just about to build up a group of fighters and tough guys. I don't care about that. As long as there's a place you can come in, train, have good fun, lose weight, learn a discipline, learn martial arts, that's what we're doing. All the guys are like a family. They stick together. They help each other through problems. I think the martial arts and everything that you learn, yeah, it calms you down, man. You don't have to prove anything. You don't have to go out and worry about your egos and stuff. It's harder walking away from a fight, you know, you can win than actually fighting. You know, anyone can fight.
Yeah, I've conducted a little bit of research on mixed martial arts. I've interviewed a lot of professional and amateur mixed martial arts fighters, and we've talked about masculinity. A lot of them like to say that it's not something they try and build up in their personal identities when they're training for fights and whatnot, but a lot of times it really is.
Floyd is an old, weak bitch.
So if we think about huge superstars in mixed martial arts, sometimes you see that kind of very violent, glorified, toxic masculinity where they use gendered language in order to denigrate their opponents. It's very difficult to separate these toxic forms of masculinity with professional sports fighting and training, because that notion of masculine dominance and violence is so embedded in the fight sport culture. Unfortunately, much of what drives too many young men's masculinity is that positive feeling that accompanies the ability to unleash violence on somebody else. Most of the violence that we know of is not in professional sporting settings. Most of it will happen between friends, in a bar. Alcohol lubricates violence. So for young boys and men, we're oftentimes socialized to believe that violence is part of our masculinity, that we can bring violent behaviors into our identity as ways to assert being more manly. If you think about it this way, when we're about to cross the street, what's the first thing you instinctively do, right? You look a certain way to make sure you're not gonna get hit by a car. It feels natural, it's immediate, it feels instinctive, but that's something we learn over time. It's the same thing with fighting. If a young boy or a young man has learned over his life course through his whānau, through the media, through his male mentors, that the fastest way to not be disrespected is to say, hey, let's throw down. Then that becomes instinctive, but it's not instinctive, it's not natural, right? It happens that quickly because it's been learned over time, but that also means we can unlearn that over time with work.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the MMA Bouts 3x3 rounds.
Are you ready? Go! Come on, fight!
Round one.
I'm not putting that belt on anyone else but you, right?
No. See, my boys do well pushing me. I want to go out there and perform. It's my time, brother.
All right, ladies. Better and better. We have one more scrap on the line. Let's make some noise. Oh.
quite overwhelming because when I'm walking down, I see like a massive crowd of my family and I feel their presence and how loud they are. I can sort of block it out quite well and I can focus on the fight and just know that, you know, even though I'm real nervous, like it's just me and this guy.
Round one.
You know, like, I don't want to get knocked out, I don't want to lose. But at the same time, that's what drives me, my fears.
First round comes to an end and all action is promised from both these guys. Good run.
I want you to set him up a tiny bit, bro. Work the body a tiny bit.
The feeling of losing, it just doesn't sit well, so it sort of drives me and gives me that energy. I keep going.
How would you score that one, John?
It's a tough one. From the looks of things, it may be one round apiece.
Last round, my brother. He's going to come out like a muck this round. You find an opening, take him to the ground, keep the pressure on him. One more round and you're the champ. You can do this.
Good show of sportsmanship to start the third and final round. And it could definitely be up for grabs here going into the final round.
It is a cool, be cool mentality.
Ants finds his way to the clinch. Very nice double leg. Great third round playing out in front of us.
He's strong, man. Like, you know, he's real strong. He took every shot and ate it and just kept walking forward. I was surprised because now I'm not used to like going my full power. I'd think I'd at least daze him or drop him, but he really just ate it and just kept walking forwards.
Your winner and new champion, Amos!
It's a crazy feeling. You know, that's what I really do live by. Like, I want to feel that feeling again. I'm thankful for the people around me and my family and friends who do continue to guide me on my way. MMA has helped me a lot. It's made me realise that what I was doing in the past is, you know, it's not that great. It's humbled me and, like, shaped me to the man I am today. Toughen up and be a big man. That's all my brothers wanna become. Everybody's like an actor. What does it mean to be a real one? Put my worries in my palms. Trust that I cannot remain calm. No, I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one.